So vitae omnes. Today we're looking at the first and second conjugation passive. Now, when you're looking at the passive, you remember if a verb is passive, instead of doing something, it's being acted upon. And for the endings, for the present, imperfect, and future, just remember it goes are, ris, tor, more, mini, entor. All right? And that signifies that instead of I love something, amor, I am being loved. Amaris, you are being loved, versus amas, you love. Amatur, he is being loved, versus amat, he loves. Amamur, we are being loved, versus amamus, we love. Amamini, you are being loved in the plural, versus amatis, you loved. And amatur, they are loved, versus amant, they love. So remember, you have those passive endings, and those are used for the perfect, for the present, imperfect, and future. Now, the perfect system is formed differently, of course, and we'll talk about that in a second. You can see the vowel here for the first has the A all the way through. The second has an E. It goes moe or, and hopefully you're writing this down. If you need to stop it so you can take time, that's the beauty of these videos. So we have an E here going all the way through for the second. Okay? Now, for the imperfect, you have the BA, just like the active. You have the vowel here, the A, for the first, and E for a second. And you just combine it with the R, RIS, TOR, MOR, MINI, ENTOR. Of course, so AMOR me, I am loved, or I am being loved. AMABAMOR with me would be I was being loved. Make sure to put that down to remind yourself. I was being loved, I used to be loved, I kept on being loved. Okay? And it can be a simple past as well, I was loved. Amabor and moebor would be the future. So you have the bobis bit going on again, but with the endings, R, RIS, TOR, MOR, MINI, ENTOR. Okay? You have the A and the E combined, joining them to the stem. But the big difference here is this. The Romans don't like to go virus, they go varus. So instead of using an I here where we would expect from knowing how the active goes, they use an E. So it's amabor, amabaris, but then the I comes back. Okay, so please make sure. And then the last one is like bovis bit, bimus bitus, bunt. So it goes bor, baris, bitur, bimor, bimini, buntur. And for the second conjugation as well, first and second. All right, now the perfect system is a lot different in that we're using the fourth principal part or the perfect passive participle for the perfect, pluperfect, and future perfect. And so amo, the fourth principal part of amo, is amatu. So you go ahead and use that. Same thing here with motus. All right? Now you'll say, oh, what happens here, Mr. Davis? Well, remember, the fourth principal part is an adjective. And so when you go into the plural, sumus, instead of talking about I goes to we, or you versus you plural, he versus they, or she versus they, that instead of going us, now this could also be ah or depending on the gender of the subject, then when it goes plural, it would go the letter I, A-E, be moti, motai, or mota in A if it is neuter. So remember, this is an adjective and it has to correspond with the subject in case, number, and gender. Okay? So it would be nominative, plural, masculine, feminine, or neuter, depending on the gender. Same, and then the singular would be the same way. Okay, for the perfect tense, in the passive, you use sum. And you just conjugate sum like always. Now the trick here is how do you translate it? You want to say, I am loved. No, don't do that. Okay? This is perfect. So it's I was loved. Or I have been. Have been loved. You can say, you can use I was loved or I have been loved. You were loved, you have been loved. He has been loved, he was loved. Okay, but not say is. If you say he is loved, that would be amatur. Okay? And then for the pluperfect, we use eramaraserat for both, all the way through. And this would be amatus eram, be I had been loved. Amatus eras, you had been loved. Amatus eras, same thing with motus eram. I had been moved. Motus eras, you had been moved. not have. Have is the perfect. So put have over here. Make sure you put these down. Put a big note to have here. Future perfect is the last one, of course, which you do not use that much at all in English anymore. Amatus ero, I will have been loved. So it's ero eris erit, erimus eritus. Instead of going erint here, like the active, they go erunt. So that's the big difference between the active versus the passive. All right, erunt. Okay, ero eris, and you use both, with again with the fourth pencil part. Okay, and this would be I will have been loved. Make sure you put the English down. You will have been loved. He will have been. Will have been. Same thing with motus. I will have been moved. And there we go. If you have any questions, please ask me in class. Well, late omnes, lingua latina est vita.